Nifty 50 is India's benchmark stock market index made up of 50 of India's largest listed companies. These 50 companies are present in the Nifty in varying proportions. For example, the largest stock as of now is HDFC Bank, which has a weightage of over 13%. Next in line is Reliance Industries with a weightage of over 9%. ICICI Bank has over 7%. Infosys at a shade under 6%, and you know, so on. So when you invest in a Nifty 50 index fund, in a sense, you would be investing in all of these stocks in the same proportion as the index. But what if I told you it was possible to invest in all of these stocks, with the difference being that your money would be allocated to all of these stocks in the same proportion? An equal share for every share. Presenting the SBI Nifty 50 Equal Weight Index Fund. In this fund, every single stock of the Nifty 50 index will have an equal weightage. This means that roughly 2% will be allocated equally to all the 50 stocks. So you'll remember that in the Nifty 50 index, HDFC Bank has a weightage of over 13%. But in the SBI Nifty 50 Equal Weight Index Fund, it will have a weightage of only 2%. Likewise, Reliance, ICICI Bank, Infosys, all the constituents of the Nifty will also have weightage close to 2%. And this will be followed for all the 50 stocks. So what's the purpose of doing this? It is seen that larger Nifty companies hold more influence due to their higher market capitalization, whereas smaller Nifty companies have negligible influence. Look at the bottom 10 companies in the Nifty 50. They barely contribute 0.5% each to the index. So even when the smaller companies do well, it does not move the needle on the index. On the other hand, if a large company fares poorly, it has the capacity to drag the index lower too, due to its higher weightage. Having equal exposure to all 50 stocks will ensure that no one stock can dominate the index. And here's proof. We backtested this strategy for the last 24 years. How would it have performed compared to the Nifty 50 index? And here's the answer. The Nifty 50 Equal Weight Index would have outperformed the Nifty 50 index by over 2%. In fact, rolling returns of the past 1, 3 and 5 years do point to the same trend. Outperformance of the Nifty 50 equal weight strategy compared to Nifty 50 index. Over a 1-year period, the Nifty 50 equal weight strategy outperformed the Nifty nearly 61% of the times. Over a 3-year period, it happened about 53% of the times, and over 5 years, this number is over 53%. Since all 50 stocks have an approximately 2% weightage, this strategy does well in periods of broad-based market rallies, not in polarized markets where only a handful of stocks or sectors do well. This equal exposure, therefore, lowers the stock or sector concentration risk, allowing you to benefit from the overall growth in the economy. This is not to say that the strategy always does well. There have been times when the Nifty 50 index has outperformed as well. But you should know that the maximum outperformance of the Nifty 50 equal weight strategy over Nifty 50 has been nearly 33%, and the maximum underperformance only 9.5%. The rebalancing of the SBI Nifty 50 equal weight index fund would be done quarterly. This means that every 3 months, if any particular stock or stocks has seen a rally, and therefore, the weightage in the portfolio has gone up because of this, the excess would be sold off and reinvested in those stocks whose weightage might have fallen below 2%. For more information on this scheme, please contact your advisor or mutual fund distributor. Thank you very much for watching. Happy investing.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.